today we had a good chat this morning, and several things really stand out. Obviously, the changes in the business from 2019, 20, 21 to 2022 and 23 in terms of how much has changed and the adjustments that have taken place in valuations in the business and how firms have had to evolve and change and shift. But also we talked about the regulatory regime and why SIFMA now, more than any other time that I can recall, is extraordinarily useful to its members, but also a useful tool for Chairman Gensler as he comes up with a significant number of new regulations meant to add to the transparency, the efficiency, the clarity, take risk out of the marketplace. But I think we helped him. You know, I started in the business in the 1980s, and as I say oftentimes, I've said it, it was an issue where there was absolutely no diversity, specifically no gender diversity at all. And that has evolved from the 1980s to now, where it's significant gender diversity. We got more work to do, but there's a significant amount. Now I think our work has to take place with racial and ethnic diversity, which I'm focused in on. And I'm really proud to say that virtually all of the firms that I speak to and all of our SIFMA members really are focused on this as well. So we're making some substantial progress. 2023 has been amazing. I think 2024 will be a breakthrough year for us. At SIFMA's 2023 annual meeting, I discussed all of this and more in a session with SIFMA's president and CEO, Ken Benson. Click through to watch our full conversation.